How you doing,
boy? This is Ethan Swallow. This is the high school orchestra.
Take the individual of each one of these kids. Got to pick up a battery in the pocket, right?
Thank you.
family, friends, and welcome to West Hempstead High School's 65th commencement exercise. My name is Adam T. Hopkins, assistant principal, director of student council for West Hempstead High School, and I will be your master of ceremonies this evening. At this time, I'd like to introduce our invited guests. Welcome to Mr. Daniel Weeman, our superintendent of schools. Superintendent of Allen Park Schools. Mr. Joel Press, Assistant Superintendent of Business at West Hempstead. Mrs. Neil Riley, Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum and Instruction at West Hempstead. Mr. James D. Tomaso, High School Principal. High School Assistant Principal, Mrs. Michelle Mann. We've got a senior class advisor, Mrs. Nancy Gunny, Ms. Diane Montiello. I'd like to welcome members of the West Hempstead Board of Education, Mrs. Karen Rome, Mrs. Andrew Shinsala,
closer to the end. Our sitting here has been nothing short of a roller coaster from the rocky beginning, anxiety of what's next, where do we go from here, what does life have in store for me, to the final stretch. We all came together to turn gravel into strong, solid concrete, and for that, I am forever grateful for the class of 2019. Cheers, graduates, for this isn't the end, but the start to a bright and better future.
Really interesting for me and making this journey entertaining. It has been amazing being president of this class. And now, a few words from the very well-respected and intelligent Dwight Schrute. I am ready to face any challenge that is foolish enough to face me. Congratulations to my fellow graduates, friends, and to all the families.
Thank you, Autumn. Thank you, Arthur. It's now my pleasure to introduce the class of tutorials, Isabella Paul.
Good evening. Being a student at West Hempstead High School has allowed me to discover my love for many different aspects of life. I've been given the opportunity to meet countless inspiring people. These individuals have pushed me to do better, lifted me up when I've been down, and they've been there for me when I needed them the most. As we are all realizing now, high school was over in the blink of an eye. For that reason, it is imperative for us to recognize the genuine people that we've met throughout our time in West Hempstead. I have known Mr. Wilson and Ms. Rogan since I was in sixth grade. Throughout my 7 years of knowing them, they've showed me the true meaning of friendship. Mr. Wilson and Ms. Rogan have been with me through every obstacle and every joy of my middle school and high school experience. I cannot express the extent of my gratitude for all of their support. I can accredit my success to numerous people in my life, but my family is by far my greatest benefactor. My two major father figures in my life, my dad and my cousin Martin, have done nothing but love and support me throughout my entire life, and I cannot thank them enough for that. My sister Sophia will always be my go-to person, no matter what is going on in my life. We have faced countless difficulties together, and our bond is what always allows us to overcome them. My mother has taught me many things, to always stay positive, to always be truthful, and to love everyone. Most importantly, she has taught me to never give up. No matter how hard life knocks her down, she gets up stronger every time. She's the toughest person I know. She's my role model and mentor. Above all, my mom is my best friend. Words cannot describe how grateful I am to have her as my mother. I would be lucky if I become half of the person she is. There's not ample time for me to thank everyone who has influenced my high school experience. My track coaches, Mr. Gray, Mr. Benedetto, and Mr. Gerwitz, I'm not sure if they're here, but yeah, have had a tremendous impact in my past 4 years. They've introduced me to a sport that I never thought that I would like, let alone fall in love with. Their passion and dedication has translated into my own, along with the rest of my teammates. I'm beyond grateful to have had coaches that have not only been there for me on the track, but the ones who have been there for me through every difficulty that I've faced. Their constant sincerity and tenacity has resulted in my team's overall success. I'm beyond lucky to have had such exceptional individuals as not only my coaches, but my friends. I have learned that many sentiments in running can be translated into other aspects of my life. As the African proverb states, if you want to go fast, go alone, but if you want to go far, go together. Running is not an individual sport. To make it far, you have to stick together and support each other through the tough times. Leading a team isn't about being the best, rather it's about being there to lift everyone up. With that, none of us here would be graduating if it weren't for those around us, whether it be our friends, teachers, administrators, custodians, or family members. As we enter the next chapter in our lives, we must keep in mind what West Hempstead has taught us, whether it be to care for others or to give everything we do our absolute best. Moreover, we must remember that at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how much money you have in your bank account. Rather, what matters is how you impact those around you. It is crucial to find something in life that you truly love doing. Without that true passion, you will never be able to live life to its full potential. I'm beyond grateful to be the salutatorian of the graduating class of 2019, and I wish each and every person here the best of luck in everything that they do in life. Thank you for an amazing 4 years.
Thank you, Isabella. Now it's time to introduce the class of 2019 valedictorian, Marissa Sheehan. Yeah!
couldn't be prouder of all of us. I think we can all say we have come a long way since freshman year. Some of you have improved academically, others socially, and some of you may have just gotten really, really tall. I unfortunately cannot say I have experienced the latter of those, but whichever category you fall into, we have all undeniably grown as a community. I know that when I look back in high school, I'm going to remember the teachers who got us to where we are today. I think we'll all remember how Mr. Gray gave us entertaining history meetings, and Mrs. Rowland kept us well-fed and even staff. Mrs. Rowland, thank you for the candy, you'll be in contact with my dentist. Every teacher in this school has molded us into the people we are today. They've given us their time every day, every year, and I want to take this time to thank them. I want to thank every teacher for answering every question we had, boosting our confidence when we doubted, and being there for us not only academically, but emotionally. It is not always easy to feel at home in school, but these amazingly caring educators have provided us with a home in their classrooms. As many of you know, I didn't grow up in West Hempstead. I came to West Hempstead in the middle of 8th grade with no friends, no knowledge of the town, and unaware that I apparently looked Japanese to some people, but you can decide that for yourself. I really did get lucky with the people who became my friends. Sure, they may have thrown pencils at me at one time, or obsessed with the live-action Dumbo movie, or even force-fed me Oreos, but this year wouldn't have been the same without them. I'm really proud of the people there today, and I can't wait to hear from them in the future. Now to the people I'm lucky to call enough to call my family. When I was 5 years old, my parents bought a pizzeria. To some of this may seem insignificant or unimpressive, but my parents built this business up from nothing. A few years earlier, my parents had lost their house and had to move to a different city with little money, little support, and a baby on the way. My father worked hard every day to provide for us, and my mother managed to make a small apartment feel like a castle. My mother is the strongest woman I know, and my father is my hero. I hope to be just as hardworking and courageous as you both are. You both are everything I aspire to be, and I'm so grateful to have you both in my life. Now, although my younger brother is off in Pittsburgh, I still want to thank him. This year, he protected me and helped me both mentally and emotionally. I'm so proud of him, Mikey, and I know you'll do great things. Then Peter, my older brother. I want to thank you for being my role model. You are altruistic, kind, creative, and intelligent. Thank you for all your advice. I promise to try to listen to all. Lastly, I want to thank my little sisters, Faith and Sophia. I saved you two for the last for a reason, and it wasn't to complain about how one of you steals my clothes and the other one forces me to bathe. I saved you till the end because you guys are my best friends. I wouldn't have made it through this year without you both. You have been there for me when life was crumbling and when I felt perfect. You are amazing girls, and I'm so proud of how much you've grown. I've loved watching you mature, and I can't wait to see the women you become. Thank you for always lifting me up. I promise to always do the same. I know this moment is bittersweet for a lot of us, but I can't wait to come back and see how we all did in whatever path we pursue. No matter where we go, what we do, we will always be a part of the West Hempstead family. We may forget how to integrate an expression or use an affair in an essay by Mr. Curriculum, but we won't forget the values of honesty, creativity, and bravery that West Hempstead has instilled in us. I'm so honored to be going to NYU, and I'm lucky that I'll be so close to many of my friends, especially my best friend, but for all of us, whatever we choose to do after high school is going to be something new and different. The last 4 years have prepared us for this moment. It's up to you to decide what the next 4 will lead you to. Thinking about our future can be overwhelming, but everyone here is capable of success. We can never give up when life gets hard, for a lack of success is only a failure when you let it defeat you. It's easy to fail. Ask anyone who's taking this synchronous AP English class. The hard part is getting up. Today is the culmination of years of hard work, and each and every one of you should be proud. As Walt Disney once said, the way to get started is to quit talking and start doing. I'm sure many of our parents can agree with the first part of that statement, but it's true. The only way we can be the people we want to be is to do something about it. My fellow graduates, our dreams and goals await us. It is time to live the reality that we want. Ahead of us is the rest of our lives, and I hope every one of you lives every moment like it's your last. Congratulations to the class of 2019. We finally made it.
Thank you, Rissa. It is now my pleasure to introduce our superintendent of schools, Mr. Daniel Raymond. Please come to the podium.
Good evening, congratulations. This part of your journey will be completed momentarily. You are about to embark on a new life. High school is a place where you try on different paths, attempt to unravel your values, beliefs, and abilities, and confront the daunting task of what's next. Steve Jobs said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the result of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. School systems, as currently constructed, can have the tendency to stifle independent thoughts, creativity, innovation, etc. It is my hope that you reclaim these ideas and lead the life you intend. Please give thought to the following ideas: fail, dream big, and ran proud. They say you can search anything these days and claim to have knowledge. Use the Google, use the interwebs. I'm not so sure I agree with this. Real knowledge is found all around us, at times and in places we would not expect. The most important card you can carry in your wallet is your public library card. Embrace the dork in you, develop yourself in risk-taking based upon learning experience, your gut, and garner the thoughts of those closest to you. As well, listen to the dissenting voice. This day and age comports itself with a lack of intellectual curiosity. We hear a cacophony in the numerous echo chambers. And if someone disagrees, questions, or even contemplates a viewpoint which is not aligned with their own, you are immediately disregarded. Not being trapped by dogma is not just a willingness to stand tall against the rain, but to stand in the discomfort of others' thoughts without accepting them. To have a well-rounded thought or position, you must be willing to consider many ideas. We all want to be right the first time, but reality presents a different vision and different viewpoint. Some of our greatest accomplishments are results, right or otherwise, of failure. Failure can turn weakness into strength. Failure can turn uncertainty into steadfastness. Failure can turn a fixed mindset into a growth mindset. Working hard and pushing yourself beyond what you are capable of the expectation. Understand that when you work hard and push yourself, you're going to stumble and fall. Pick yourself up, dust yourself off, work harder, push yourself further, based on what you just learned.
Wait.
Too many times, I have observed people meandering through their daily lives, believing that this is their lot in life. Too many times, I have listened to people tell me how they have a job currently as a result of appeasing someone else's hopes, dreams, and expectations. Too many times, I've seen people drag that up because they were not content. Going into the workforce, find a job, work hard, gain experience, capitalize on an opportunity, and read. You're going into the military, work hard, learn a big life lesson, and read. You're going into college and university level, work hard, graduate early so your loans are not exorbitant, and read. The people are closest to me come from all walks of life. However, they all have the essential truths in common. They set goals. They work hard. They learn daily. And they respect all people, but they're fiercely independent in thought. Research shows that if you write down your goals and refer to them on a daily basis, you are 75% more likely to accomplish them. 75% more likely to accomplish them. Think about that. That's rather impressive. So I say this to you. Dream the biggest dreams. Don't dream small dreams. Dream the biggest dreams. And I'm going to tell you why. Your dreams are supposed to be so big they should scare you. Dream so big that your family and friends give you that pregnant pause. Do the dog head tilt and look at you like you're crazy. Greatness never occurs if you dream a little dream. Bobby and Andre and Wilbur Schwantz who wrote Dream a Little Dream of Me had it all. Whatever your dreams are, make sure they're gigantic. Bring the bride back to each of you this day means something different. But remember this, you will always be a Ram, you will always have a home here, and if you ever need anything, all you need to do is ask. Whether you're going to college, into the workforce, or into the military, you're going to be adopting a new nickname, a new family, if you will. No matter the nickname, no matter the family, you're always going to be a Ram, you're always going to be a part of the Ram family. Congratulations once again, and Godspeed.
Thank you, Mr. Raymond. It's now my pleasure to invite West Hempstead High School's principal, Mr. Jamie Tomaso, to the podium to address the class.
Thank you, Mr. Hopkins. I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate the class of 2019 and share my thoughts with the graduates and their families tonight for a few moments. Students, it's truly been a pleasure getting to know you as individuals and as a class. You have earned the admiration of the entire school community, and I humbly thank you for being who you are, for being role models for the underclassmen, for being leaders in so many ways, and for your willingness to take on any challenges. I want to thank you for making my first year at West Hempstead one that I will cherish and truly remember. Parents and guardians, thank you for embracing change and your support. Your children are on the doorstep of graduation because of your caring and love you provide. You have guided them to this point in their lives and were able to take on all the obstacles along the way. But before you accept the diplomas and prepare to move on, be proud and reflect on a few moments that you've accomplished together. You should be proud and celebrate the fact that you have mastered many academic skills you needed to graduate high school. Many of you have excelled in the classrooms, while others have advanced in the arts and on the athletic fields and courts. You have earned your high school diploma, despite the many roadblocks you may have faced along the way. I am extremely proud of all of you and your families as well. How about a nice round of applause for the parents? Speaking of taking on new challenges, this is something that I am recently familiar with. When I changed school districts 28 years ago, I was somewhat hesitant and apprehensive. Why should I change? I was comfortable with what I was doing and set my routines. Why leave security behind where I was respected and established, where everyone knew my name and reputation? But I made a decision it was time to do something new, a new chapter of my life here at West Hempstead High School. It was daunting and no doubt not an easy decision to make, for sure. But now looking back after my first year, it was the best decision I made in my professional career. I have an opportunity to meet new people, learn new things, and become part of something special. Because it gave me the opportunity to cross paths with all of you here tonight, this was a risk worth taking, and I haven't looked back since. Like I did, graduates and parents, you will be writing a new chapter in your book of life in a few minutes. Students, you will become alumni. Parents and guardians, your children will soon be high school graduates. And the class of 2019 will be moving on and out of the halls of West Hempstead High School and away from the school safety net that you have been so familiar with. I am here to remind you that it is now time for you to take a new risk. Moving forward, I know many of you may be uncertain. You may even be a little scared and excited and anxious all at the same time about what lies ahead of you. A wide range of emotions is expected. You will be moving on with your careers, onto new college campuses, and places with unfamiliar faces. You may even be afraid to fail. Everything you are feeling is normal, and most high school graduates and families are feeling like you are right now. But to make successful changes, you must embrace them and set new goals. Without new goals and expectations that you put upon yourselves, things become comfortable and easy, and often people settle for this way of life. But if you challenge yourself to start again, you will find new experiences and joys beyond your imagination. You will find yourself on a new course and a new road. There will be no doubt there will be moments of trepidation, but if change were easy, everyone would do it. If leadership were easy, everyone would lead. If starting over were easy, we would just do it. But these things are tough to do. I challenge you again, take that risk, step into uncertainty, and go after your dreams. Be willing to start over when you fail. Lead when it is difficult. Change to make yourself better and learn from your mistakes. You will find yourself at a place closer to your dreams, I can assure you. Now, to summarize my thoughts, the advice I would like to impart on you for the future is something that I think you already know, but mirrors my previous stated sentiments. It's a simple quote from a Hall of Fame hockey player who some consider the greatest ever to play the game, Wayne Gretzky. He stated, "You miss 100% of the shots you never take." Class of 2019, you certainly took many shots, scored many goals, and achieved many great milestones these past 4 years of high school. It is my hope that you keep this effort through, even if your shot is wide or you hit the post or the crossbar. Class of 2019, keep chasing your goals in life. Take a risk worth taking, and I can guarantee you, you will be closer to finding happiness. Students here before us have some extraordinary, have been extraordinary in so many ways, and I would like to highlight the one noteworthy and incredible feature. This year, we had 43 seniors attain a Silver Court status. You may have noticed that they are proudly wearing them tonight. This is a four-year commitment in which students needed to volunteer their time in the form of community service. Students with a Silver Court, please stand.
You shake it every day.
Lazar.
Donato DeGusta.
Diaz.
Amanda Lashley. Chelsea Moore.
rights. Christian Reyes.
With the sideburns.
Bernard Richardson. Natalie Rivera Martinez. Ian Wall. Talia Wright.
And the Board of Education, it is my pleasure to present the class of 2019.